artist, and I'm a designer more than I'm a quilter. I'm an architect who makes quilts, which is very different than a quilter who makes art. The result sometimes is similar in that there's a picture on a quilt and there's a picture on a quilt, but they are wholly different in terms of design intention, and you can see it in the work, right? My work is more sort of seated in spatial kind of faceting, and their work is more seated in, you know, really colorful fabric that they've kind of learned how to put together to make something that people can relate to in their community. Some of the quilts I make take hundreds of hours, 400 hours, you know. And it's just me doing this precise thing for the vast majority of that because I make each of the squares. Similar to that quilt on the wall back there of the landscape, you know, you see where I make each of the squares, and then sewing those squares together makes the full image. That piece is done in a different way, but you can see the same idea, whereby making each of the squares have all the details, and then sewing it all together, the details form the whole. So I'm here tracing and cutting and gluing and listening to trashy science fiction novels. My bed quilts, I tend to make them really simple as well, just because then the geometry isn't lost on the bed. Because if it's too detailed, you kind of lose something in function. And so just a really simple geometry lends itself much better to a bed quilt. Plus, you want it to be something that people are going to use. It's just like, you know, kind of throw it on your bed, use it, get it, you know, drool on it, right? That's what it's made for. Well, I was working in architecture and just sort of decided that working in architecture is a difficult avocation. You're just like working for developers, making them some cash. And, you know, if you're lucky, you have either saved up enough or met the right people in a 40-year career to make a good piece of work. And I'm like, I'm not going to wait for 40 years. I'm going to, you know, go out and make bad work until I make good work, you know? And it's like, but I want it to be my work at the end of the day. And also, I feel like I have far too much to offer to sit around and wait for someone who happens to have resources to trust me to make something good. So definitely, I'm going to go out and make my own resources. And at the end of the day, I've made a project that I was the, you know, fully involved. Like, I made a project, right? And for better or worse, you know, I certainly have made bad quilts. But I've learned from it very specifically, right? I've learned a skill set based on what I'm trying to do. And that's far more important to me than making someone else some money by drawing toilets for 12 hours a day.